Charlie Hodgson.
Charlie, it's brilliant to have you here with us tonight, celebrating a great cause and a fantastic player. Can you talk about what makes Danny such a deserving talent of the recognition we're giving him tonight?
Well, I suppose even from the days when he was back at Leeds, the little scraps that I used to have against him, and celebrating what an amazing career he's had, both from a club point of view and internationally. He is a dynamic player, he's a brilliant player to watch. He's obviously a tough player to play against when I was playing, and I'm really pleased to be here supporting him.
Of course, it's nice to have the rugby community coming together for a cause like Nordoff Robbins. Does that feel special for you to be a part of?
It's amazing, yeah. It's amazing how close this rugby community is. I was pretty humbled by it last year when I was generously supported by this dinner. So to be here again, to seeing so many sort of familiar faces and friendly faces, it's absolutely amazing.
Of course, and it's an amazing time for rugby fans. We have so much to look forward to this year. What are you most looking forward to, obviously, with World Cup and Six Nations ahead of us now?
Yeah, I mean, it's take your pick, isn't it? There's still a domestic season to be played. There's the Six Nations on the horizon. We've got the European Cup to eventually get to the final stages. And then, of course, the World Cup at the end of the year. So there's so much to look forward to. Could I pick one? Probably not at the moment because there's so much to play for. But, yeah, really excited by it all.
I think we're starting to see Six Nations squad announcements. Obviously, quite a few new faces in some of those squads. I'm curious if there are any young players you're especially excited to see emerging on the world stage this year.
God, that's a tough old question. That there's so many out there to really pick. And with it being so close to the World Cup, I wonder how many coaches will actually take that punt and go for those young boys and blood them in. So there's some exciting talent out there. As I said, I couldn't really pick one because there's so much, but really excited to see where they all progress.
In terms of England, obviously, after a blistering start under Eddie's tenure, we had a slightly tougher period, and now I think there's a renewed optimism going into this year and all the opportunities ahead of us. How are you feeling about England's chances, particularly with the Six Nations, obviously a tough opener with Ireland?
Yeah, it's obviously a very difficult task to start in Ireland, but the boys have got a good squad. Like there's a good depth there. There's a good understanding there. They've obviously had their blip, but they came through the autumn period actually with some good results, and so they'll take a lot of confidence from that. I'm sure they won't let last year's Six Nations affect them too much, and they'll go into this one full of positivity, I'm sure.
Do you think that Eddie is still very much the man to take England forward at this point?
Well, of course he is. Yeah, I mean, it'd be ridiculous to change anything right now. Eddie's had his team now for a few years and knows what he wants and knows the team that he's trying to put together, and that won't change. What happens after the World Cup is anybody's guess, but he won't be too concerned about that. I don't think many other people would be too concerned about that. It's just getting through the Six Nations period first and foremost.
I guess my final question, it's obviously exciting to talk about all these big international competitions, but at a grassroots level, what do you think we should or could be doing to help support the sport more and to encourage those stars of the future?
Do you know what? I think a lot of it is happening already. Good things are happening already. There's a lot of, from my experience, there's a lot of professional players who are going back into the community and spreading the word of what they enjoy and what they do. I certainly know from retirement the enjoyment I get of being at a local rugby club on a Sunday morning, and that's the reason why I got into rugby in the first place.